opponent safe switches into a bomber snow, and Marwild's about to have a tasty little snack. Welcome back to the channel. We're about to do our one and only Spring Cup upload, and today we have, without a doubt, one of the most ridiculously toxic teams you will ever see. If you're easily offended, this probably isn't the video for you, because my commentary is probably just as toxic as the team that Ty has put together. As always, huge shout out to my good friend Ty, the king of entertainment, for the footage. There's not too much more to be said, so without any further ado, let's get into the battles. And in game one, Ty leads Shadow Torterra, or should I say Shadow Torterra, into Lantern. Our target has been acquired. The opponent safe switches into Tentacruel. Despite their sub-poison typing, these neutral rays at least still tearing through the opponent. Ty shields up the acid spray, then pivots into Kingdra. Kingdra going to be looking for the full Dragon Breath farm down. However, the opponent is going to reach one very rude spray. We get sprayed in the face, but Kingdra doesn't really give a flying fuck. We commit to the full Dragon Breath farm down. Back out comes Lantern Ty, farms up. Full sends the outrage, does the opponent respect the damage? They do not. Lantern gets rocked deep into the red. The silly electric fish does leave with a surf, which will hit Torterra's ground grass typing for neutral, but we survive the damage. The opponent then pivot out into Roserade, and the opponent's about to be in for a bad time. We fire off the Sand Tomb, not only forcing a protect shield, but lowering their defense. We send out Marwile, and that very quickly is going to be all she wrote. GG's, and thanks for playing. Roughly, Torterra doesn't fancy the work of the flying banana tree. We safe switch into Kingdra, and the opponent answer with Quillfish. I was going to say Ty was going to have to use some sort of skill rather than just RPSing the shit out of his opponent, but the opponent clearly has no response, and we're very easily going to be able to take back switch. Ty correctly shields up the Sludge Wave, commits to the Dragon Breath farm down, and normal service will be resuming very shortly, with Ty frantically tapping his screen and just fast move beating down everything. The opponent throws the Leaf Blade, Kingdra actually survives. We don't reach a move. Does it matter? Probably not, because Marwile is an absolute wall to this banana tree. Switch probably will be everything. This meta is not all that complicated. I imagine the opponent's running grass, double water. Ty probably fought the same, however this opponent's actually running ABA grass, so they're core broken by Marwile, and Torterrible is looking very terrible in this battle with nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. Absolutely dead weight, but it's probably better in this matchup than the Tropius matchup. We fire off the Sand Tomb. You might be thinking, why does the opponent shield? Well, what the heck else are they going to shield, as we really aren't going to be throwing all that many charge moves. We send back out Marwile. Luzcon is probably getting hit with a flash cannon. We shield up the Power Whip. Ty gets the full Fire Fang farm down. Back out comes Tropius, and Tropius is going to get Fire Fang farm down. And Marwile says thank you very much for the very tasty snacks. Moving on to the next one. Another lost lead. We see the pivot into Kingdra. The opponent stays in, likely looking for the chip and dip. Kingdra takes neutral from everything in a Bomber Snow's arsenal. They chip us with the Weather Ball and then pivot out into Poliwrath. Ty looking to reach the outrage. The question is, does the opponent respect the damage? Outrage! Oof. Go shielded. Boo, Mr. Opponent. Ty kind of forced to shield up this Icy Wind, as it's going to be double super effective. He also did not wait out his clock. So after we've Razor Leaf farmed down this Poliwrath, we're going to be switch locked when a Bomber Snow does return. Back out comes the Snowman. Ty looking to stall the clock, throw in the Sand Tomb. Sand Tomb actually forces the opponent's final protection. Switch timer pops up. Marwile looks for the snipe. Unfortunately, unable to snipe before the opponent reacts, throwing the energy ball, rocking us below half health. The opponent's final Pokemon is Jellicent. Usually this is a pretty dreadful matchup. Have a Ty, still one Protect Shield, too high behind. Full sends the Play Rough. Play Rough lands for huge damage. The opponent is most certainly in one Razor Leaf range. Ty, still one Protect Shield, too high behind. Razor Leaf farms down, and that is all she wrote. Interesting matchup. Both Pokemon going to be hitting each other for super effective. Holy crap, this is not a neutral matchup whatsoever. This is an absolute assassination. Torterra living up to its name as Torterrible, absolutely deleting that threat in the blink of an eye. The opponent then sends out Squidworth. Torterra going on an absolute rampage, forcing a Protect Shield with the Sand Tomb. We pivot into Kingdra, drawing out Ferrothorn. We see the instant no shield deployed. Ty grinning ear to ear, knowing that his Kingdra has baited out this stupid steel spiky bush, which is going to be a very tasty snack for our Marwile. We fire off the Octazooka. I don't think we got a debuff. Not that it really matters, as this opponent is going to die so quickly to these Fire Fangs. Ty going to shield up a potential Flash Cannon. The opponent full sends the Flash Cannon. It looks like Ty looking to stall the clock out, wanting to pivot back out into his Torterra as soon as possible. The opponent makes a huge mistake, dumping energy. The opponent throw the Scald. Scald isn't quite lethal. They do manage to poison jab farm down. However, can they make another move? Of course they cannot, as Torterra far too oppressive. Heading into the next battle. It looks like the algorithm is not a fan of Ty's very toxic nonsense team as he keeps losing lead. We pivot into Kingdra, drawing out Poliwrath. This non-stab Icy Wind won't be lethal. Ty tanks the damage, farms up, full center outrage. The question is, does the opponent respect the damage? They do not. The opponent fucked about. They're about to find out that Ty is about to be the RPS king, ruining this trainer's life. The opponent sends out Mawile. Mawile does get the Fire Fang farm down once again. Torterrible looks absolutely dreadful in this matchup. Dreadful into the entirety of the team, other than Poliwrath, which you can never get aligned onto. However, really, does it matter? Absolutely not. As two shield Mawile for the tap-tap beatdown win. Perhaps I've called this a little bit early. Ty also didn't throw at the best time in there, giving the opponent a free air slash. Of course, the air slashes are resisted. However, Mawile rapidly running out of HP, the opponent makes a huge mistake, throwing a charge move. Trainer, we've got two shields. Just tap your phone, try an air slash farm down. I think that would have actually been a tie if the opponent didn't throw a charge move, but regardless, Ty takes the dub. Torterrible into Squidworth, the battle of neutral damage. The opponent looking to harshly lower our defense, aka by two stages, with the rude spray to the face, but undeterred, Torterra withstands the damage, returns fire with the Sand Tomb, also giving the debuff effect. The opponent invests that protect shield. Ty, happy to take his shield advantage, we send in Kingdra. Is this a blind Scald? Yes, it is, and that is double resisted, trainer. However, they do get the attack drop, so Ty likely pivots. We pivot into Mawile, drawing out Sea King. This goldfish likely running triple legacy. These poison jabs are single resisted due to steel, double resisting poison and fairy taking super effective. Of course, the opponent bait, as we've got two protect shields. Ty looking to go for a cheeky masturbating session of his own. Poor defenseless cats getting killed left, right and center. I think we're forced to shield up. Another Icy Wind. Ty does get baited for the second time. He's going to return fire with the Poliwrath. Poliwrath, even one stage debuff, going to secure the knockout. It's now Abomasnow versus the world. Ty resets his debuff, sends out Kingdra. The opponent's going to need to double up on charge moves. They're certainly in one Fire Fang range. Icy Wind isn't lethal. Can we Dragon Breath farm? Now we cannot. Do they have the charge move bank? No, they don't, but we get one turn bring in. Not only do we get one turn bring in, the opponent get new mechanic. The algorithm says, Ty, if you're going to run RPS nonsense, Niantic is going to do everything to give your opponent the dub. The opponent wins, but they certainly shouldn't have. However, it is what it is. Moving on to the next one. We see a prime example of why I hate Razor Leaf. These wing attacks that actually get same type attack bonus are hitting us for super effective. The Razor Leafs are only hitting for neutral, but the damage output is far in favor of Razor Leaf. Ty makes a very nice double resisted weather ball catch onto Kingdra, drawing out Abomasnow. We should survive this weather ball, which we do, but we're not going to reach the outrage. Ty is going to have to settle for an Octazooka. This also won't be lethal. However, the opponent actually invests that protect shield, which is best case scenario, and we get the 50% chance of lowering their attack. We can now send in Mawile. Ty is going to leave this matchup with a 2 to no shield advantage, and we've got energy. What can core break a two shield Mawile and Torterra? I have no idea. We send out Torterra, we'll get the snipe. The opponent's final Pokemon is Ferrothorn, and Ferrothorn is in for a very rough time. We fire off the Sand Tomb. Sand Tomb forces the opponent's final protect shield. The opponent's going to get a massive bullet seed farm down. However, Torterra going to once again lower this poor Ferrothorn's defense with one further Sand Tomb. Oof, we're in the bait game. Ty sends out Mawile. Luzcon is going to be getting hit with a Thunder or Flash Cannon. We shield up the Power Whip. Ty able to outpace to the Power Up Punch, and Power Up Punch is going to be all she wrote. GG's. Heading into the next battle. We lead Shadow Torterra into Poliwrath. What a dream lead. The opponent say switches into a Abomasnow and blink, and you might miss it on the screen as Mawile is going to have a very tasty little snack. The opponent fires off the energy ball, which is resisted but still lands for massive damage. Ty tries to stall out his clock. The opponent sends in Poliwrath. We reach the Poliwrath. Does the opponent respect the damage? No. Holy crap. We only reach a good big charge move about once every 10 battles, and every opponent respects the damage. Ty now sends in Torterra, looking for the one shield and Razor Leaf farm down. The opponent dies at the Icy Wind and say no thank you and concede the match. Heading into the final battle, we see a very, very tricky lead. Oof, how do we beat a Galarian Weezing? Due to the fairy poison typing, our razor leaves are resisted and Kingdra's dragon breath will be double resisted. Although these razor leaves still chunk because razor leaf is by far the most degenerate move in the game, or perhaps his charm, both are fucking annoying. And you can see these razor leaves are doing huge damage. The opponent fire off the sludge. Sludge doesn't get the job done. Ty looking for the razor leaf farm down. It looks like Ty can actually just razor leaf completely through a poison type, which is just absurd. Out comes Ferrothorn. Ty pivots into Kingdra, saving Torterra for a potential water type in the back. The opponent fire off the power whip. Kingdra just about survives. Ty looking to reach the outrage. The opponent banks a boatload of energy, send out lantern. Vasili electric fish is going to be hit in the face with the outrage. The opponent is going to get a very nice spark farm down. However, we can send out Torterra, commit to the razor leaf farm down. We're going to be able to debuff this Ferrothorn, and this game looks as good as over. Even if the opponent leaves this matchup at 100 energy and they're running Flash Cannon, one Flash Cannon isn't going to be lethal. It's moment of truth time. Do they have Flash Cannon? Even if the answer is yes, they're not going to be able to reach another move, as I think one further Fire Fang will get the job done. It's actually two, but regardless, Ty takes the dub. Huge shout out to my good friend Ty for submitting some battles that certainly are not my playstyle. I hate fast move pressure. However, I think this meta is absolute nonsense. So if you just want to get some battles done quickly on the final day, give this team a try for yourself. So if you're enjoying the content, smash that like button. If you're new, consider subscribing. If you like your battles featured on my channel, a link to our battle submission form is down below. And as always, a huge thank you to everyone for watching, and I'll see you all in the next one.